Hey guys, JT here. So I'm here now at my backyard. So as you can see right there, it's my shovel. So I'm trying to shovel the snow over here in my backyard. Let's see, because I'm going to set up my tent in there. Because the weather today it's really nice, so I have to shovel snow as much as I can so it won't be cold when I set up my tent in there. So hopefully we're going to sleep in there tonight. Alright, so yeah, I already started a little bit in there, but yeah, it's not enough. So it's my tent, it's really big, it's like an 8-person tent, so I have to make my area a little bit bigger. So yeah, okay, let's get it on. Sorry, so this is my tent, guys. So yeah, I thought it's a 8-person, but it's only 6-person tent. So I bought it on Walmart on sale on this fall season. So I never used this one since I bought it. So I guess this is a perfect time to try it out on the winter camping. So yeah, I have here my tarp. I have to use it underneath, put it on the ground so the tent won't be lying on the ground. So I have the tent first, the tarp, then following by the tent. So in that way the tent won't be get wet. Then inside the tent I will put another tarp also, so to keep us a little bit warm. Then after the tarp inside the tent, I will put another rubber thing. It's kind of a puzzle rubber. So yeah, all right let's get this one on. First time that I set this one up, so it's kind of a little bit tricky because it's my first time, so we'll see how it goes. right now and trying to assemble all the tent poles. So I will figure out later which one I'm going to use. So I think it's easier for me to assemble it first. Then I can figure it out later on. I might need to look at the pictures of this tent in the carrying bag. So these two here, they are the same. A little bit shorter than this two here. Come across the other side.
propane. Yeah, this thing is really big one. Put my anchor on this one. So
yeah, the tarp that I put underneath kinda small, but it works for the meantime. So the soil right now, it's really hard because it's frozen up, and look at my tent pole, it's bent down. trying to stretch it out with my hand. Should get some hammer. Right now I can feel the cold in my feet. And I will put my heater inside and test this one out. Just
really hard to figure it out this screen type. If you have a big tent.
Alright, it's all done and set up. So now I'll just leave. I have to anchor all this tie. This one. I have to anchor it on the ground because it's windy a little bit. Yeah, right now it's temperature is around +7. +5, something like that, and overnight the temperature it will go to -5. Yeah, so we'll see how it goes, and I will put my heater on there, and yeah. I grab my hammer now, so it's easy to pound on the ground. So right now I'm inside my tent. Yeah, the temperature inside in here, it's really nice compared outside. The only concern is the ground. It's a little bit cold in the ground because I'm only wearing my socks on. So I will put this tarp as additional flooring. Yeah, it's really nice in here. Some rope. Some grommet came off. Yeah, this stuff is bigger. I should use this one as my base before. The blue one that I put underneath the tent is smaller. This one is really big. But it's nice to be covered. This tarp is really... I forgot what's the measurement of this one, but it's really, really big. And it's a little bit expensive. But at least it will serve the purpose. Yeah, I have to move this one. Where are you going to do it? Yeah, it's a little bit bitter now. I put additional tarp on the floor. I'm sweating a little bit. Perfect. Winter camping. So I have to put the rubber, what do you call this one? Puzzle rubber on this floor. Okay, I will go and grab that one. So I have my. I will use two. Two sleeping bag. So just in case if it's really cold. So not especially this one here. So, you can see this one. And this one here, yeah, because this one here is just a mesh, so the air can get in. So, and all over here, so it's all mesh, and for sure, the cold can get inside on this one. But we'll see. So I will use two heater for this one, an electric heater and a propane heater. Yeah. So that we have more heat in here inside. Okay, I'll go grab my another additional layer of flooring, the rubber one. Sweating again for walking back and forth. So I just bring my heater here. See, so it has a safety features on it. Tip over, so if it tip over, it will shut off. So it will stop heating if it's tip over, so you will not burn inside in here. But of course, I will put something that kind of hard, maybe a wood. So the wood is. It is stable on the ground. So this is the rubber thing that I'm talking about. got only this 8. This one's not too open. Yeah, we bought it for our kids, but we never use it. So they never use it, I mean, but so this one, it will be perfect. We're going to use it in here. A little bit better now. I mean, way better with this rubber thing on. So yeah, I think this one is all good. So I'll just leave it. The sleeping bag. Bring a sleeping bag on. So I will be sleeping in here inside with my wife and the kids. Maybe they will sleep in the house. So maybe my son, he will come with me. Sleep with me in here. So this will be our sleeping area here. With a sleeping bag. We're going to use 4 sleeping bags. So 2 for me and 2 for my son. So it will be really warm for us. How was that? Perfect. Not cold. Not really cold. So this is where will be my heater. So I put my heater in there with a piece of wood. It's around like 4-inch thick wood. And this is my power supply here, coming from my house. So yeah, it's not yet hooked up to the wall, outside wall of the house. So if it's a hook up, there's a kind of light in here. In here, that it's already powered on. So yeah, it's good to go. Maybe I will move this one. There. So yeah, it's stable. Yeah, so this cord is already powered up. As you can see, this light here, that's the indicator. And to verify that, so we can test it with this heater on. Okay. It's blowing some heat now. Yeah, it's yeah, I can feel the heat. It's really warm now. But I don't know what will be the temperature in the night time. So I will put that one in there, and I have another backup. My propane heater. Yeah, you can see the little bit hot. You know, the air like smoke. It's hard for you to see in the video, but in here you can see a little bit. So maybe this side I will put my propane heater, or maybe on that corner over there I will put my propane heater. Because I know it will be cold during the night time, because as you can see the top, it's all mesh. The only thing that covered this one here is just the rain fly. So all the air will come in on that one. So yeah, so it will be cold. Because this tent is not designed for winter, it's for summertime. So yeah, I just tried this one out because for this temperature, it's really nice. Be warm. Yeah. So yeah, and that's our sleeping bag that came with this tent when I buy, and also this chair. Yeah, it's very sweet, eh? It's really nice and warm inside in here as of the moment. So, and I got another two sleeping bag additional, so it will be nice and cozy. Hope I'm hoping in the night time it's really warm. But we will see. That's why I just tested it out in my backyard. If it's really really cold, then we can just climb up and go inside. It's an experiment, guys. So it's not fun if you're just staying in your comfort zone. So this is what we call winter camping, eh? So, yeah, my heater in there, it's It's running. Tripod. And I will bring my other propane heater, Mr. Body Heater. Alright guys, so see you later on in the night. I think it's already done in here and it's good to go, and it's time to prepare our dinner. It's already, let me see what time is. I mean, maybe 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Oh, my other phone is dead. So, let's see. Oh, it's not dead. It's just dark. The brightness. Yeah, it's 2:58, so close enough to 3 o'clock. Yeah, because my battery on my other phone is 4%. So should charge this one. Alright guys, see you later. Hey guys, JT here. So right now we're on our tent. We're going to sleep here for just one night. So I have here my heater, my propane heater.
Yep.
And my other electric heater.
Yep.
So, and my son, he's the one who take the camera.
Yep, it's me.
And right now, I'll show you the temperature. So,
your phone smells bad.
The temperature right now, it's hard to, yeah, it's close to around 18 degrees. Around 18 degrees Celsius. So yeah, as you can see there, it's rising up to around 20 degrees Celsius. Yeah, or 19. Yeah, so yeah, that's my propane heater. There's my electric heater. So, and I have here my carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide detector. So just to be safe. Okay. Alright guys, so we're going to sleep now. Just, we'll see you in the morning. It's really dark in here. I'm using only my flashlight right now. Morning guys, it's already 4 a.m. right now, my propane heater is run out of propane. So right now it's only my electric heater. It's running, and the temperature right now inside is around 8 degrees inside. It's already 4 a.m. So yeah, 1 pound of propane bottle, it's about It will run about for 4 hours in low settings. So I think we need to go inside the house because I'm going to use a washroom. And maybe also just continue our sleep in there. Because right now it's really windy in here. You guys, that's all for this winter camping. Yeah, the temperature is not really that bad inside the tent. So, yeah, it's a good experience. Okay, thank you. I will show you the temperature here. Just right there. It's 5 degrees now. Yeah, so about 5 degrees Celsius. And there's my heater. Electric heater, as you can see, there's some frost in there from the propane bottle. Yeah, as you can see, the wind, it's really windy. So, hey guys, so JT here. Today is Sunday morning. Yeah, it's very windy right now. So I'm starting to pack my things up. So this is my sleeping bag. I got 4 sleeping bags here. And I also use a Reflectix. This one, Reflectix. So keep us warm. It's very windy. Okay, so I'm trying to do it faster. It's very windy.